All right, let's look at practice exam 3, problem number 10. Let's do part A first. All right, so we want to have two reflections to map a triangle ABC onto the triangle XYZ, which is congruent to triangle ABC. All right, so let's do that. So open up GeoGebra. I'm going to just create a random triangle using a polygon. So you just say click here, click there. I'm just making a random right triangle there. All right. So what we're going to do is I'm going to let's see, first choose this triangle and make a duplicate. So you have a copy and paste. All right. Then I'm going to just drag it out. Right. Then maybe rotate it a little bit so that it's not really facing in the same direction. So I can probably do something like, let's see, go here and we can rotate. So rotate this guy around this point. I don't know, 32 degrees, some random angle. So we have that. All right, then what we're going to do is I'm going to hide this one. So that's A1. So these guys. So A1. B1, C1, and then, and I think it's this. Oh no, that not that one. I want to hide this guy. All right, so that's that. And then I want to call these guy X, Y, Z. So instead of D, I'm going to rename it. Right click. So that's X there. And then this is going to be Y. So rename to Y. All right, and this is going to be right click, rename, and that's Z. All right, so you have X, Y, Z. So we have two kind of random congruent triangles. All right, so I'm going to apply two reflections to this guy to match exactly to the other guy. All right, so let's do that. All right, so we're going to look for a perpendicular bisector tool. So we can just you can use actually any vertex, but the matching one would be this one, and A and X are corresponding ones, right? All right, so what we do is we're going to do a line reflection. So go down here, reflect about the line. So I'm going to reflect this guy about the line we just created, right? So you can see that we could match A to X. All right, next, I'm going to create another, so second reflection. So we're going to pick another bisector. All right, I'm going to do this guy with Z. All right, then we're going to apply line reflection. All right, so you can see that the reflection is matched exactly with the triangle XYZ. All right. So this is a transformation that requires two line reflections to match triangle ABC right onto triangle XYZ. All right, that's it. I hope that this was clear.